All I can say is that hearing Douglas's work, he is trying to bring you into a kind of trance-like state, which you lose track of time and space and personal position. It's easy to be drawn in. It can be intensely rhythmic, or it can be very noisy, but whatever it's doing, it's trying to take you out of your normal everyday self. That's the critical thing, I think, with it.
You know, I learned as a youngster that music is any sound that is pleasing to the ear. I've since come to the conclusion that that can't be so.
This is Douglas Ewart. I first had class with Douglas in my sophomore year of college. I began working on a project with Douglas, which was intended to be a series of interviews with musicians and artists working in Chicago. I enlisted the help of my classmate Alex Brown, and we began shooting interviews. It quickly became apparent that the energy Douglas brought to the camera was unique, so we decided to focus the film on him.
You know something? I didn't sleep at all last night. And when I go to my class, I surrender. I mean, I give up everything. Teaching is the ultimate performance, really. Yeah, it really is. You have to be completely naked. Anytime you're not, you're bullshitting, because you got to fuck up and be ready to fuck up liberally. See, if you play cagey as a teacher, you're bullshitting, you know, which means all the protective things like you know and all that crap. You don't know shit.
When I first started making instruments, many people tried to discourage me. I perused the recycle shops. I perused the alleys on my way home from work or to work, or that's part of my work, is gathering things, because very valuable things are discarded. This is a lid from a pot that's been painted. This is, of course, for the skier's, to lock the skier's foot in. This is a sterno holder, which is wonderful. They're items that are in their twilight of function, twilight of their original purpose.
There's an obsolete coin that's a clapper inside of this tube, and makes that beautiful sound.
around the living room, which was a very much a musician apartment. We've got wooden floors. There's a bike hanging, you know, from the ceiling. He would just methodically move through it, his eyes closed, just completely into his music, not forcing it out. It was just flowing out, but it would go up and it would go down, and it enveloped you. But you could go in and you could see he was in that zone. He and his instrument were in another place. They were delivering something for all of us, but they were another place. I could have called his name if I wanted to, and I don't know that he would have even heard me. Not because he was ignoring me, because he's so deeply connected with his music and his craft. I see his eyes closed. I see him moving around and walking and just playing.
Other sax players, you know, play like jazz saxophonists. Douglas doesn't play that way. He's real open. He plays sound. Within the sound, it just builds into a thing which is multi-rhythmic, multi-timbral, and it has peaks and valleys. And it kind of goes in different directions, but you know, it's happening.
You're not really playing the music, you're playing you're telling your life. Music, it maybe is a product of something you do, but it's not really that is important. I think we're using the music as a metaphor of being connected to each other.
You know, you have silence, and then it's what you put over that silence, and then the silence is part of the music. And I always think of music as having like quality of love is like the predominant quality that it has. It's like a force of attraction. It's a force that unites people and brings things together.
If I'm connected with somebody, and that means I am honest and I'm displaying the pure part of my soul to people. A lot of times I fail, you know. I think a few times in my life where I feel like, yes, you know, I really got it. And sometimes I feel like, no, I didn't do that well. You know, and you know, I repeat this process, and hopefully every time I do it, I get better.
And I see the world as music. You know, it's life. I think, I know it's life.
Over the next 3 years of shooting, Douglas' interest in rediscovering his roots surfaced as an important theme in his life.
Sometimes when I come to town, I'll just come by to check Keith out so we can talk in our own language.
I pick up the phone and I hear it's Douglas. I mean, say to him, you know,
What's a gwan? You know.
Wamsa.
A wamsa. You know, interpreting something like that, even. Or not having to interpret it.
Yes.
You know.
Yeah.
That you can say that to somebody and they know exactly what you're talking about. Carry me a kigwal instead market, not a quarter wassail. Carry me a kigwal instead market, not a quarter wassail. Oh, Lord.
Not a bag, not a bag, not a Saturday night. Say, Lord, not a bag, not a bag, what a Saturday night. Everybody come feel up what them.
We organized a trip back to his childhood home of Jamaica. He was intent on tracing his lineage back to the oldest living member of his family on the Ewart side.
This is Newstalk 93 FM, broadcasting from the University of the West Indies, Mona Campus.
It is my distinct honor and pleasure to have with us this evening Douglas R. Bully Ewart. Welcome.
It's a pleasure to be here. It's a pleasure to be home. They say grow a child in the way it should and it will return to the original concept or to the early influences. I think from the people that would sit on their porch and say to you, boy, how you what you do to school today, or I'm watching you, you know. Or just the way they would call your name would envelop you with a special feeling, which they meant to impart to you is, you know, do your part, grow up to make something of yourself.
If there should be a first friend in my life, then when I say Bully is my friend. He would be one of probably the first persons for me to recognize that I am getting to have sense now that you know somebody, sense of knowing. We start to creep. I know I creep before him, so when him a creep sometime, I have to catch him up too, you know. I'm going to watch him grow till we start to probably play marble. We start from the ground, and the more we start to get older or to get in age then you could see his thing was more of people, just don't forget where you are coming from. Because if you forget where you are coming from, you don't know where you are going.
I'm interested in looking at that evolution, looking at what is the history of a family. How much of your fortune as an individual is influenced by the people from which you come?
They say they've gone as far as they can go. I'm not happy, as you can tell. Well, I'm not sad either.
So is it back to word of mouth?
Back to word of mouth, maybe taking some blood, sticking up a couple people. Oh, man.
Douglas had been given information from a man named Papa LaSalle Forrester that there were Ewarts in a small town called Bluefields. Upon arrival, Douglas realized that he did not have Papa LaSalle's contact information. We set out to find Mrs. Forrester, who Douglas's cousin Dickie knew.
So we could go over to the lady house now before it get dark.
Then call her.
Yeah, then no, but you mean Miss...
Miss Brown.
Yeah,
Brown.
You mean call her first. Yeah. Take her now, Dickie.
Number,
yeah? You have
her
number. Yeah, Mama says she have it, but... old number, she don't know if it still works.
Old number, don't know if it still works. Oh,
Yes, I'll find the number.
You remember where those was? Mm-hmm. Let's just try that. We'll soon come back.
All right.
You're a part of this young Rastafarian movement.
Yes.
In East Kingston.
And I actually live with Powdy, Brother Powdy. I thought I'd spend some time amongst them, thinking that I would avoid having to deal with some things at home, only to be confronted by things that I would have confronted at home and additional circumstances of responsibility.
Well, he come to camp through his cousin, Herman King. Everybody come in and now nobody want to go home. Everybody want to stay by me. We play the drum to the music, and when we play the drum, they blew the instrument.
It all adds up that whatever needs to be done, do it now. But because when you're young, you looking up the road, it looks like life will never end. It looks like it will take forever for you to get to 60 or 70 or whatever, you know, when you're a young person. So you're inclined to waste a lot of time and in doing things that you don't really need to do, just like too much fun things. You know, too many girls, too many good times. Then, when you finally get up to 60 or 70, everything becomes much shorter, you know. It's like you're looking down the barrel of a gun. And you're realizing that it will soon be all over. Soon be all over.
In the island of Jamaica, the food we eat is very nice, especially in the parish of St. Mary. The food they eat is very good. Banana, banana, banana. In the island of Jamaica, the food they eat is very good, especially in the parish of Portland.
Woo!
The
banana.
The food they eat is very good. Oh, banana, banana, banana.
Yeah, and your tiger. I see one wolf there too. Lock them all up. All the tiger there right there, so. Our brother named Ashley. Ashley Forrester.
From down
there. Our papa Lassell Forrester.
You mean the brother of country?
Yeah.
Dickie is here asking for you, him and him brother. He passed the way for you.
Not for him, yeah.
Where you go, Wilson Road and turn right, the last
street down right. The one, the last right.
Yes.
Yeah. Don't go with her boat. She must have too much sugar.
She all right, you know. She gone to work.
All right, Miss B.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
I didn't write it down, you know.
This is East Avenue, by the way.
East Avenue, what is street?
West Avenue.
West Avenue.
You want West Avenue?
Yeah.
It's other one around that side.
It's on that other side. Yeah. So if I want to go back, I can just go along south.
You could go right here.
And make a left.
Immediate left. And then you go straight out to the corner and make the next left.
Left.
Up. Depends on where you're going, up or down.
All right.
All right.
Yeah.
1B.
Over the street?
Yeah, man, 1B on this street.
Yeah, man, right up here, right at the same street.
Yeah, walk across, you know.
Where are you from, Miss Forrester? Leave it open here.
Yes, sir.
Hey,
let's go here to see
Miss Forrester. But I came and saw you and you gave me Papa Forrester.
Oh,
and
Ashley's brother.
Ashley.
Yeah.
Ashley.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
As the brothers.
Mm-hmm. Which one is the farmer? Both of them are farmers?
Well, more Lassell.
Lassell. Mm-hmm. Cause I remember I had to wait for him to come from the field to talk to him. Because
yeah.
It seemed like he's still.
Does
he's still doing his farm.
I don't know because he had a back problem.
Well, I'm going to try. So Ashley is that your brother-in-law?
Yeah.
Yeah, he knew the grandparents.
Yes, yes.
And he said that's where they were originated from.
Okay.
Yeah, he wanted to link him to some of our kinfolk. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So I'm going to call Papa Forrester.
Yeah.
And see if he can give me some information, and then I plan to go down there either tomorrow or Monday.
Yeah. And the second mission to
Africa,
which ended up in Ethiopia.
Yes,
Douglas Mack was a part of that mission, which also included someone like, say, Brother Sam Clayton.
Yes,
and condolences and support to Sam, who just
lost his wife.
We meet with peace and love, and we part with peace and love. Because it's peace and love that cause progress for us to find our way out from whence we came and where we are going. And things keep going wrong and wrong and wrong. That's why I clock. Eh? Yeah. The clocks are 5 to 1 today. And tomorrow, the second past the day. And the same, you know what I mean? It's going wrong and wrong. And so everything keep going round and round. And we look at the planets, we see them going round and round. And the world behavior pattern of everything. You see?
Keep cool, Babylon, you don't know what you're saying.
Yeah.
Keep cool, Babylon, you don't know what you're doing. Keep cool,
get Alpha coming soon.
Keep cool, Babylon, you don't know what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Keep cool, Babylon, you don't know what you say.
Tell you, keep cool, Babylon.
and good, you know what you do. King Alpha coming soon.
Second verse.
He come with lightning and thunder to clear the way. The whirlwind come and blow it away. Keep cool. Keep cool. Keep cool. King Alpha coming soon.
Visiting Brother Sam reminded us of the way in which Douglas uses music to communicate. In particular, we were reminded of a workshop in Minnesota at the Hennepin Medical Center in which Douglas made small shakers with the patients.
What a highlighter. Highlighter won't work.
Okay,
let's see. Let's stick this. Oh, you don't want that to happen.
Mm-hmm. And I write like at the top of it, like I had ECT, the electric therapy you put on your head. And so I wrote ECT at the top of the page, and then I write this, and it's a prayer and an intention, and it digs into that.
It
draws from that spirit.
Let's see what happens if we try Papa Forrester. Good evening. I was wondering if I could speak with Papa LaSalle. Papa LaSalle Forrester, Mr. Forrester. Mr. Forrester, Papa LaSalle Forrester, isn't that Ashley's brother? He did? My name is Ewart, Douglas Ewart, and I had spoken to Papa a few years ago about coming to Westmoreland because he knew the Ewarts there. Ewart, E-W-A-R-T. Ewart is the name. Yeah, I lost by not getting his father. He sounds like he's having problems hearing. Yes, W-A-R-T is the last name. You don't know them. No.
No. Yeah. Ewart is the name. Ewart. Ewart. Yes, the old man died. Fuck. Damn. Because the old man knew the whole, knew the everything. The old man knew everything.
What I find interesting about Douglas is his anxiety and interest in finding about where the Ewarts came from and who they are and so on. It's important because you need to know who your relatives are. It seems that the Ewart parents never went out of the way to introduce their children to their other relatives. That's why I really appreciate what Douglas is trying to do.
There was a man named Papa Lascelles Forrester.
Okay.
He knew Grandma Ewart.
Oh.
And he knew some Ewarts in Bluefields.
Okay.
But when I called him today, he's deceased. You know, Gene, what this says to you is anytime you get a piece of information, you can't wait. I should have went the next day to Westmoreland.
Life is your time on earth. You're born. You didn't ask to be here, but it's your time on earth. You live it the best way you can until it's ended. So you find that as time passes and this one passes on and that one passes on, you know, you find that it's coming down to a few on one hand. So you feel a little isolated sometimes. So that is loss.
So you ever gonna play any of my music, or are we gonna just be listening to these people, man? They hear this all the time, man. Well, them can't wait to hear this, man. Me might dead tomorrow. Oh man, the time is almost gone. What you gonna play?
We have lined up something from Douglas. Let's hear what he has to do with some Jamaican forms.
Good evening. My name is my name is Douglas, and I called a couple evenings ago and spoke with Mr. Astley Forrester. And I'm in Belmont. I don't know if you'll be able to help me, but I'd spoken to Papa LaSalle when he was alive, and he knew some of my relatives. Oh, I just want to talk to him, you know. I just want to talk because we're gonna continue our journey. Can I stop by your house for a few minutes and then you could talk to me and I can move on to Cave? All right, I'm at the Breadfruit Club right now. How do I get to your house? Hold on, I'm gonna have somebody that lives here tell you where I am. Hold on. There's a gentleman at the shop.
Tell him my name. I'm Mr. Mac.
Mr. Mac, I'm looking for Mr. Forrester.
Which of them?
Astley.
Oh, Astley just around the corner there, man.
Yeah, he will tell me how to get to you.
Yeah, man.
I'll see you in a few minutes.
Tell him that you're by Mr. Mark Sharp.
So I'm by Mr. Mark Sharp, and he'll tell me how to get to you. I'll soon come. No, no, go down. Him say we'll see a high seawall, and then we'll go around, we'll see a low seawall. That's one of them dread you right just so where Mr. Astley then. Astley. Mr. Astley. Then we'll know him from such.
Yo, sir. Love. You know Mr. Astley?
Astley. Yeah. Is which one? The purple, the purple.
Alright. Is it on your right hand side?
Yes.
So after you pass that big white house, that's up.
Yes.
See here I go in the corner there.
Yes.
Not that house. The other one.
Alright.
Next door.
Alright.
Right hand side.
Alright. Love
so
right.
Whole heap of house there.
Okay.
Yeah man. Alright.
Time. Yeah, I'm saying a whole heap of house in the yard.
So we're going in
here. Yeah, man. Bill Nunn. Hello. I'm looking for Mr. Forrester, please. Mr. Astley. Next door?
No, I'm here there.
This one right here?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Hello? Mr. Astley? How are you doing, sir? I'm Douglas Ewart.
Douglas what?
Ewart. Ewart.
Ewell.
Ewart. Ewart. Douglas Ewart.
Ewell.
Ewart. You know, Ewart from Cave.
Ewart, man.
Ewart.
You know, you didn't tell me wrong, man.
No, man. So I was trying to find out if you knew any of the Ewart from Kiev.
His name of his father was Gilbert.
Gilbert, mm-hmm. Yes.
Indeed, I have a sister named Netta Ewart. She live up high up in the hills. Yes. Me and she have line up in the top. Come from all there too.
She's still up there?
Huh?
Netta's still alive?
Yeah, man. You know her?
No.
Well, she's still alive, man. So where are you from?
I'm from Kingston originally, but I live in the U.S. Okay. Yeah, I live in the U.S. So I'm down for a couple of days and I have to go back. So I was trying to see how much, get as much information as I could. Maybe I'll try, see if I can get up to Netta's. But you just, when we go back out here,
yeah.
You just go up there.
You drive?
Yes.
Well, listen to me now, you can't miss it. When you catch out there, you will see the shop there.
Yes. The shop where me did Mr. Mark a while ago, or not that far? From so? Yeah.
Catch the bridge.
Yeah.
All right, if you turn on, but you can't have
somebody. Ask somebody for the back road.
Yes, and then go show you.
All right.
And I hope you might get you.
I appreciate your help, Mr.
Today is Monday, January 3rd, 2000. I'm here getting ready to interview my mom. Mom, what is your full name?
Sybil Hyacinth. You want my first name before I was married?
Sure.
It's Kelly.
Okay. Where were you born, Mom?
I was born in Kingston, Jamaica.
You remember when?
No. I know the date, but I don't know what.
The date? Year. What's the date?
8th of April.
8th of April, 19...
I must say 1917.
Yeah, 1917. What about your boys? What were your boys like?
You are the one always so friendly. Jump on the man cart and ride down the street every morning. You remember that?
Papa the Bread Man.
You remember that?
I remember Papa the Bread Man, but I think Bunny used to ride on the cart more than me.
No, son. You're the one used to have on pants and nothing up here. Don't you used to walk around half naked?
Yes.
Well, every morning that bread man used to deliver bread at our house. And Mr. Gentleman here, and funny, I wasn't strict on that thing, so come out. He jumped on the cart and ride with the man every day.
You want me to come on?
Yeah, man, that would be great, man. Move over. How you doing?
Okay.
All right.
Hi. Miss Netta?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to our house, and we don't want it to get too dark before we get there.
Miss, what's your name?
What's your name?
Miranda.
Yeah. Look at that beautiful sunset. That blue shop?
Yeah.
It's right, that's where we're going?
Yeah.
You want to get out and go back down, or you want, or is it okay for you to come?
That's okay.
All
right. Right here.
Can drive you?
Yeah.
Yeah, where you say, man? Is that you, what?
Norman.
Okay.
Pat, you what?
Okay.
Ellison. Exactly.
Ellison, okay. Yeah. I don't know if she related to me, but I'm trying to connect,
man.
So
that's good.
I'm a Ewart.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
You connect then, man.
I've never met your branch of the family. Mm-hmm. I'm actually know you about you because of the Foresters.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I had called them. I actually talked to Papa.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe about 2 or 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. And he said he knew some Ewarts.
Yeah.
That I may be connected to. Mm-hmm. No, man, we take time,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, man, but just a jog.
My grandfather just a jog.
Because sometimes even we can't remember.
Yeah, yeah, man. She good band that.
My grandfather, but she's 92.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So I figured she's right in that bracket right that person, would know something.
Yeah,
or may.
Right. What? Wrong time on the plate, you know, girlfriend. You have multiple visitors.
All right, thanks.
How will video you to you get to go on the camera too? Like what them do on TV and stuff.
I can come on now. I can pass out and pass. I'm going to
be careful. Come up the plate. I am covered.
Man, she is sharp, man.
Yeah, man. Yes, man. Just last week, she walked to church. She walked to church last week.
Hello, Miss Mother Annette. I'm Douglas Ewart.
Oh, Lord. Nice seeing you, sir. Nice
yes.
Knowing you.
Yes.
In our old days. Well, old, you know, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, 90 and 2.
90 and 2.
July, God, I'm a birthday.
Okay. What was your father's name?
Gilbert Ewart.
Gilbert, that's right.
Yes.
Mr. Forrester mentioned that.
Yes, Gilbert, you are.
What would you advise a young woman that's looking for a man? What would you advise her?
Ensure you this face.
Yes.
If you're married, you only marry that different face.
Okay.
You. If they're wrong, they want you to get them right. You can't wrong or get right.
Yes.
No. You're wrong, you're just wrong. Whether it's what he begs or not, you tell him the truth. Right?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Tell him the truth.
So the truth is an important
thing. Yes, yes.
I love when you say the truth. The truth is an offense, but it's not a sin.
No, God the truth. God
but sometimes
truth.
You have some people who will tell you, talk the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And the phone ring.
Mm-hmm.
And you said, the phone waiter, tell him no. Isn't that a lie, ma'am?
Yeah, man.
Isn't that a lie, ma'am?
Yeah. Definitely.
So what I'm saying is, some people say you have a big lie, and you have a small lie.
Yeah.
So what I really want you to convince me, because sometimes I'm in that kind of argument with my wife, and
You're a liar, you're
a liar.
And the same thing.
I'm a liar, the same thing.
You're wondering how she tell me.
Here, mama.
Him won't spread the same way.
Same way. I love you, mom. Thank you very much.
Lies a lie.
Big lie, little lie. I see him lie.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I love that, mom.
Yes, yes.
Mama, you have any special hymns that you like?
You mean to sing?
Yeah. Even one. Even a piece of one. Even a dege dege one. either way. Our boy. Anything. We'll take everything she willing to say.
You know what the great physician now is near? The great physician now is near. The sympathizing Jesus. He speak the drooping heart to cheer. No other name but Jesus. Sweetest note in Sarah's song, sweetest name on mortal tongue, sweetest car on ever sung, Jesus, blessed Jesus. Okay.
Praise
yes,
I'm sure
she's
a singer, you know. She never tell me
so
she's a singer yet, you know.
It's a great one.
Isn't that nice?
It's a great one. What do you mean? Mama,
yes,
this has been
so fruitful
and beautiful.
Yes, you're so powerful.
Well, this is an interesting fact. I don't know if you guys know, but Douglas can, when I first met him, he can ride the unicycle. And there's a picture of him you gotta ask him for this picture, but it was in the Reader or something like that, of him on a unicycle playing the panpipes. This is it. I haven't seen this in probably 30 years.
Well, it's been 30 years, guys. Plus, this one ain't in the best shape.
What is it to remember that which has been lost? And that memory can be recaptured, or that lost memory can be recaptured, because someone like Douglas might have performed it, written it in music, written it into a play, written it into a piece of art, and so on. And that might be the closest we'll get to that memory.
What would you say a young woman should look for in a man?
One that is dependable, that is honest, that is gentle, that is ambitious, and stop talking stupid.
When the right time comes, you love yourself. When the right time comes, you love the human spirit. If you love yourself, you love the human spirit. Oh, left wing, oh, right wing, oh, centrist, oh. When the right time comes, your body will be out of doors.
When the time comes, it's over.
Banana.
Green, all right.
Banana.
Oh, banana.
Banana.